Hello everyone, this video is follow up to the previous one which some of the subscribers commented on and requested on how to create such a transition that I used as a demo for my previous video and make a video about it. So in this video I'll be talking about how you can transform these 2D items into 3D and create such a scene. But before, if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please subscribe, like and share this video with your friends. Okay, the first thing that I need is to create an animation like this. If you don't know how to make this scene, watch the previous video. Okay, after creating the scene, I open the items comp. And I select the layers that I want to appear as 2D objects at the beginning of the animation. And I copy and paste them into the main comp. I unsolo the layers. Let me move the comps that are for the cylinder effect forward, so I can arrange the layers easily. After that, I want to create an animation like this for them. For that, I select the layers, open their scale, and I create a keyframe for them in the beginning. I make the initial keyframes ease. I move 7 frames forward. I create another keyframe and make them linear. Then I back to the beginning and I set their scale to 0. And to have a bouncy animation, I copy the bounce expression that I use for these layers and paste it for the scale of these layers as well. I've put this expression in the comments below so you can also use it. I right click on the scale that I pasted the expression for and click on copy expression only. I select the other scales and hit Ctrl V. I come here and rearrange the layers in order so the layers would show up based on the order in the timeline. After that, I select all the layers. I move 1 frame forward. I trim all the layers down to 2 frames. After that, I select all the layers from top to bottom. Then right-click on them and under Keyframe Assistant, I hit Sequence Layer and then I hit OK. So the layers are arranged in the order of selection. Then I made the length of the layers longer. And now let's preview the result. As you can see, the animation of the layers appears in the order I wanted it. After I'm done with this, I move the indicator where the bouncing animation is over, about here. And I want to make a transition and turn these 2D layers into a 3D look. Okay, now let's work on animating this layer. I open its position, rotation, and scale. I create a keyframe for them here. I move 20 frames forward and create another keyframe for them. And I move the cylinder comps here. In the beginning, the layer is here. And in the end, it should place here. So I go to the beginning. I move 8 frames forward and move up the layer. And I create anticipation for its animation here. I rotate it like this. The initial keyframe of the scale should be here. I make them easy ease. And in the end, I place the layer here. And I match it with the layer in the comp. After that, using the pen tool, I alter the path of the animation a bit. Then I select the middle keyframes and then I have to increase their influence. For this, I can go to the graph editor by holding shift and using this handle, I can set the influence to 75. Do the same for this side too. I back to the main comp. I can do the same using the motion tools script and right here I set it to 75. Let's see. After that, I move the indicator to the end of the animation, one frame back, and I trim the layer here. And let's take a look at the animation. For the animation of the next layer, let's select this one, since there is a similar item in the items comp. For this, I can do it a lot easier by copying the keyframes of this layer. But before pasting the animation for this layer, I duplicate it so the initial position of the layer would be visible. I select the main layer and hit Ctrl V. I hit U so I can see the keyframes. I move the end of the animation over here. I delete the keyframes of the scale for now. In the end, the layer should be placed here. And I match it with the reference layer. I create a keyframe for the scale as well. And its scale should be increased too. I back to the first keyframe of the position. I select these two keyframes and put the layer here. I go back to the end of the animation, and I alter the path of the animation. Let's check it out. It looks good. Now I delete the upper layer. I go to the end of the animation, and one frame backward, and I trim the layer. At the end of the animation, I open the items comp. I select this layer and trim its beginning here, so before this frame it won't exist. Let's check it out. To solve this issue, I cleared the cache of After Effects. I need to fix it again. To make it the same size as the reference sooner, I move the last keyframe of the scale one frame back. For animating the left side items, I can use two methods. First, I can animate this layer and then put it right here behind the character. Like how I did it here. As you can see, the layer moves and is placed on the back side of the cylinder. Or I can animate it like this layer. It moves here, rotates in 3D, and then places in front of the cylinder. For that, I make this layer 3D. I open its position, rotation, and scale. I create a keyframe for the position, Z rotation, and Y rotation. And also for the scale. I hit the U button so we can see the keyframes. When this layer is here, this layer should come here. So I move these keyframes over here. I move 30 frames back. Here I place the initial keyframes. After 7 frames, I create the anticipation for the animation here. 10 frames forward, the layer is placed here. Then I put the end of the animation back in place. I make the keyframes of the position easy ease. And in the end, it should be here. When it goes back, it rotates like that. I make this easy ease. For this keyframe, I set its influence to 75. until here, Y rotation is like this. Here it rotates, and it would look like this. And it's Z rotation like this. Let me fix the path of the animation first. Here it should look like this. And for this moment, I set it to 180. And I set its rotation like this. And I delete the last keyframe of the Y rotation. And here I have to match the layer to the reference. Again, I move one frame back and trim the layer. I go to the items comp and I select this layer. One frame forward and trim it like this. Let's check it out. Alright, to better see how our work has been done, I go to the items comp, isolate all the layers except for the layers that I've already animated, and I move them forward so we can see our animation better. Well, it's good. You can continue the process and animate the rest of the layers as well. Just don't forget when your job is done and you've animated all the layers in the main comp. For the layers that are in the items comp and you don't have any layers for that in your main comp, you can show them by animating the opacity. As you can see, I've animated the opacity of these layers, and while these layers are transferring, I make the rest appear as well. I try to make them appear where not to attract the viewer attention. Continue the procedure until all of the items are appear and animated. And if you pay attention, as the layers of the items comp are appearing, their shadows are also appearing. With this approach, you won't have to worry about animating the shadows. The last point to add is that your layer's animation don't need to be identical or similar. You can use your creativity and make each animation unique to have a more attractive animation. If you are interested in making animations and motion graphics in After Effects and you're still at the beginning of learning or even a professional, I recommend you to enroll in Motion Hero course. Because in this masterclass, I talked about all the necessary topics that a pro motion designer needs with lots of practice and projects. So you have the fastest path toward perfection and you wouldn't have to do the same mistakes as I did. So enroll now and take your skills to the next level.